The Focus of Freedom, from the Freedom Tabernacle Baptist Church and Freedom Tabernacle Ministries in Atkins, Virginia. Home of Camp Freedom, a regional outreach to our youth. Freedom House, offering counseling, intervention, emergency shelter, and food distribution. And with our many missionary partners, reaching out around the world with the light and love of the gospel of Christ. And now, the Focus of Freedom.
So upon the infallible, eternal, undeniable Word of God I stand.
As always, thanks for watching this week's edition of the Focus of Freedom. New Year's Eve, everybody. So from all of us here at Freedom to all of you, Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. And I hope that all this new year coming up in 2018, God will just move and bless, and He will if we let Him. So Happy New Year, everyone. Now we're going to have some music from last week's Christmas Eve concert at the church, from the little ones all the way up through the adults. Such a blessing, and I hope and pray it'll be a real blessing to you here tonight on this Christmas Eve. Heavenly Father, as we look back through 2017 here tonight, we can locate a lot of blessings, and of course there's a lot of burdens. And so we pray for those that may be struggling under burdens tonight, looking into the new year, Lord, especially those who are battling terminal illness, catastrophic sickness of some shape or form, or some very deep financial crises, or a split in their marriage, or some problem in their family. Whatever it may be, help them to know, God, that You're right there. Through the years, decades, centuries, and millennia, Lord, You're always here through eternity. From everlasting to everlasting, You are God. And yet, You are mindful of the sparrows that fall and of the lilies that fade. And You tell us that we're more important than them. So I pray, God, we will consider the lilies and the sparrows and just know that You do care and that You are a very present help in trouble. So minister on this New Year's Eve to everyone that's looking in. I know a lot of parties, a lot of celebrations, a lot of things, Lord, people waiting for the new year, and all around the country and world, exciting celebrations and gatherings. But Lord, year by year by year by year, You're always with us. So as we do here at Freedom, always through our history, we just reflect on the blessings of the last year and have faith that those blessings will merely increase in the new year. And Lord, not just for that blessing upon the ministry here, but on all the ministries throughout the region and nation, and upon every individual and upon all their families, I pray, God, that this year, that this New Year's Eve, Lord, that You would instill hope within us, and that we would be willing to allow You to increase our faith, to know, Lord, that greater things lie ahead and the best is yet to come. And so we thank You for Your blessings and Your constant friendship and availability through the past year of 17. And we embrace 2018 and we dedicate it to You, God. And so may Your local church all throughout the world experience revival. May we as Your people be humble, prayerful, ever turning from our wicked ways and always seeking Your face, so that You would take note of us from heaven and forgive our sin and heal our land. So minister now, Lord, on this through this New Year's Eve edition of the Focus of Freedom, and may the songs be a blessing. May we be blessed, God, to see these young people play the instruments and the little ones right on up through the adult choir, everything that we will be experiencing here tonight on this New Year's edition of the Focus of Freedom. Use it for Your glory and to instill greater faith in Your people and to reach out to the lost, oh God, with Your grace. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, may God richly bless to all of our lives this New Year's edition of the Focus of Freedom.
Lay down His sweet hand. tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born.
Light of the world, glory.
was there on that silent night when your tiny heart started beating for mine. Wish that I could see the star in David's town. Turned a stable into holy ground. I sing along the angel song. Noel, Noel, Jesus is alive. Emmanuel, hope is dear tonight. So go and tell the world that death has died. Jesus is alive. Yeah, Jesus is alive. The God who made us all with these two little hands is bringing us his kingdom quiet as a lamb. Oh, such amazing grace, a divine conspiracy. This Savior in a manger changes everything. That's why we sing. Noel, Noel, Jesus is alive. Emmanuel, hope is here tonight. So go and tell the world that death has died. 'Cause Jesus is alive. Yeah, Jesus is alive. Sin, you have no sting. Hell, you have no power. Curse, you are no more. This is your final hour. Because the Son of God has not left us alone. He'll live and die and rise again, and then he'll bring us home. The old will pass away and we will become new. This baby boy is making all sad things untrue. Jesus is alive, Emmanuel, hope is here tonight. So go and tell the world that death has died. Noel, Noel, Jesus is alive, Emmanuel, hope is here tonight. So go and tell the world that death has died. 'Cause Jesus is alive. Yeah, Jesus is alive. Yeah, Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive.
They told me bum, 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 bum. A newborn king to see, bum, 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 bum. Our finest gifts we bring, bum, 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 bum. Lay before the king, pa-rum pum pum pum, pa-rum pum pum pum, pa-rum pum pum pum. So to honor him, pa-rum pum pum pum, when we come. gift to bring. Ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. That's fit to give our King. Ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. 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 Shall I play for you? Ba-rum-bum-bum-bum. On my drum.
Taught us to love one another. the wondrous gift is given. So God imparts to human hearts the blessings of his heaven. No ear may hear his coming, but in this world of sin, where meek souls will receive him still, the dear Christ enters in. Oh, Christ, be welcomed in.
And the glory of Christmas is the glory of Christ. And the glory of Christmas is the story of his love. And the glory of Christmas is the glory of Christ. And the glory of Christmas
is the story of his love.
Christ the Savior. Good morning, guys. We're kind of talking to two areas this morning. So, good morning, everybody. Good morning. Are you excited that it's Christmas Eve? Nobody's excited. There was like three yeses. Are you excited that it's Christmas Eve? Yeah, I'm excited. I think I'm more excited than y'all are. Well, I have a question for you this morning. What is this? A bell. What do you hear? A jingle bell? Does anybody know, what do you feel when you see this jingle bell? Or what do you think when you hear it? What do you think about? Marley, what do you think about? It sounds like a reindeer jingling. Anybody else down here? What do you think about? You think about Santa's bells? If you've seen the Polar Express, you probably think about Santa's bells, don't you? Well, did you know what I think about when I hear this bell? Joy. Do you know what joy means? You don't? Do you know what joy means, Marley? It is. According to the dictionary, the word joy means extreme happiness. Extreme happiness. And I get very joyful and happy when I hear this bell. But do you know that the sound of this bell actually has a meaning? A big meaning. It means something important. When I looked up what the sound of a bell meant, it said that the bell actually announces the coming or the arrival of an event, an activity, or an occasion. Well, aren't we here today to celebrate a special occasion? Yes. What occasion are we celebrating today and tomorrow? Christmas. What is Christmas? What's Christmas? Jesus' birthday. This bell is meant to announce the coming of the birth of Jesus, which is why we're here. So every time you hear a bell, I want you to remember that. It means a little something different than what you thought, huh? Now, I have a question for you. If I do this, there's no bell sound. Yeah. If there's no sound, does that announce that something's coming? No. Did you know that it's your job and my job and each and every one of our jobs in here to be like this bell? It is our job to announce the coming of an event, the arrival of our Lord Jesus Christ and his birth. And we're supposed to go and tell everybody, like that song says, go tell it on the mountain. Over the hills and everywhere, it's your job to tell everybody that Jesus was born today. Now, I want you to look here. There's a way that you can remember or be able to share this with someone. So you might say, well, I can say it's Jesus' birthday, but how do I share the good news with everybody? Well, the candy cane has a lot of symbolism, just like our little bell. And I've got papers up here for you to take home today. And you can go home and make a book. And then that way you can remember for all of your life how to tell somebody about Jesus with this simple little candy cane that you might hang on your Christmas tree. Okay? The first thing, I think you might know this one already. What letter does that make? It's a J. What do you think that J stands for? Jesus. So you say, Christmas is not about Santa, although that's exciting. It's about Jesus. It's all about Jesus. Jesus is the reason for the season. So when you turn your candy upside down, you have a J for Jesus. Okay? Then, can you describe this type of candy? What is this called? Well, what's the texture? Is it hard or soft or mushy? What is it? It's hard. It's a hard candy, just like Jesus. Jesus is our rock and our refuge, and that means that when he is for you, no one else can be against you, and that you can stand up against the world and tell them about Jesus because he is hard as a rock, and he is your rock. That's right. Then you have this way, which is how you typically see a candy cane, and that looks like a shepherd's staff. We know that shepherds went to find the baby Jesus, don't we? But we also know that in Psalms 23 and all throughout the Bible, it tells us that Jesus is the good shepherd. And he will lead you wherever he wants to take you as long as you follow him, because he's a good shepherd. Now, the last two things is, of course, how it looks. What colors are those? They're red and white. Did you know that those colors, even though when I see a red and white candy cane, I go, ooh, it's peppermint. But the red and white means more than peppermint. The red stands for the blood that Jesus shed for you on the cross, because after he was a baby, he grew up into a man, and he died on the cross, and he shed blood and went through terrible things for you because he loves you. And then that white part tells us that he can wash away all your sins because of the blood he shed. You can now be made clean, and you are pure as snow, because the Bible says that even though you might think you're little when you grow up, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And the last thing I have for you is, when you put two candy canes together, what shape? Jesus loves you. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." So not only does he love you, but you can ask him to come into your heart so that you can live with him in eternity. So do you think that you can be able to tell everybody about Jesus using a candy cane? All right, now, we've got a little something different today. We're getting ready to pray, but I'm gonna tell you about these. If you are not singing with us, I want you to get two candy canes out of this bag. One is for you, and one is for you to use to tell other people about Jesus today, okay? And if you're singing with us today, we're going to put it over here in this chair, and it's going to stay there. And after church, after we get done singing, you can come and get you a paper about Jesus and get you two candy canes too, okay? Because we've got a lot of telling about Jesus to do this morning, don't we? All right, so everybody bow your heads. You will, yeah, everybody gets two. Lord, we just thank you for these children here today. We thank you for this holiday and what it truly means, God. And we hope that and pray that we will be able to show you our gratitude, God. It is never enough. But the baby that means so much to us, who was a man and died on the cross for our sins, God, you are just precious to us. And this holiday is as precious to us as these children are, God. And we just thank you and want to be able to tell everybody about your birth and what has happened here today. In Jesus' name.
Dear Lord, it's been a joy to have shared these songs and this music with our viewers here. And as far as Eastern time zone, Lord, we've only got one more hour in this year. And Lord, it's already 18 halfway around the world. And it ain't even 18 yet, won't be for several hours in other places. But you're God through every time zone, through every century. And we thank you, God. We praise your holy name. And God, would you just bless all of our viewers? Help the preachers, Lord, that are watching to know that you're still God. And those that are going through troubles and struggles, bless them. Lord, for the homeless, those that don't have anywhere to live. Lord, I don't know why and the reason behind it, but Lord, I know that there are people suffering, and I pray, God, that you will just increase our awareness of the need and give us a greater determination in this new year to try to be a blessing. Lord, it's just not a little cute saying that we say when we go off the air. But Lord, it's true. We try to be a blessing to someone else somewhere. And though we can't be a blessing to everybody, we can sure be a direct blessing to one or two. And then, Lord, if all of your folks would carry that attitude and those actions into this new year, what a blessing it would be. So, Lord, touch every viewer now with your love and your grace and your mercy and your peace in Jesus' name. None of us know what 18 holds for us, but we certainly know who holds 2018. That's the eternal God of all time. He transcends time. From everlasting to everlasting, he's God. And right here in this little sliver of what we know as human existence and time, he's here as love, with an offer of himself, so that we could be his sons and daughters forever in the family of faith. And so he planned it out that way, and he took the risk of disobedience of man and dominance of Satan and the curse of sin, so that he could end up with something unimaginably glorious forever and ever, to have little children with him in his glories forever. So this new year, let's tell this world and everybody we can that God loves them. And the reality of our Redeemer is the ultimate eternal reality. So from all of us here at Freedom to all of you, have a great, great new year. Had a wonderful time today in the baptismal service. Grateful for those that have been saved and followed the Lord today in believers' baptism. And let's just pray that this year, 2018, would bring a revival in the church, heavy conviction upon a lost world, that churches would be revived, and as a result, many, many, many sinners would be saved. And whether churches are revived or not, man, we as God's people can just trust in the Holy Spirit and the power of God and get out here in the highways and hedges, because there are literally millions of people who need to be saved by God's grace and come to a personal knowledge of the eternal, everlasting, unconditional love of God. So God bless you for watching tonight, and let's rededicate and refire ourselves for this new year that's happening here in about an hour. May God bless the following program, Hang With Living Faith. May God bless us all together through this new year. Now till next week, may God bless you richly. Then may he use you for his glory and to be a real blessing to someone else.